Yes, dear viewers, good afternoon to you all, and welcome to you once again on today's live show organized by Prominent Consultant. And সবাই আমরা রমজানের মধ্যে আছি, সবাইকে রমজানের মোবারক। এবং যেটা হচ্ছে যে প্রতিদিনই আমরা লাইভ করছি আমাদের বিভিন্ন পার্টনার ইউনিভার্সিটির সাথে, বিভিন্ন ক্যানাডার পার্টনার ইউনিভার্সিটির সাথে, বিকজ উই আর ফেসিং এ ভেরি টাফ টাইম। ডেফিনেটলি এভরি ডে উই আর লুজিং এ লট অফ পিপল, ব্যাংকার্স, ডক্টর্স, ইঞ্জিনিয়ার্স, সো মেনি পিপল উই আর লুজিং এভরি ডে। সো ইটস এ ভেরি শকিং নিউজ ফর আস, বাট অ্যাকচুয়ালি নাথিং টু ডু, বিকজ ইট ইজ বিয়ন্ড আওয়ার কন্ট্রোল, ক্যানট কন্ট্রোল দিস। Somehow we can pray only for those souls so that they can be in peace. And of course we need to be very safe, we need to stay in home in this critical situation. But of course we should not stop ourselves to see dream, to research about our future, to that think about our future plan. Okay, so suppose you must be planning for study abroad, or you must be planning to study in Canada, so don't stop thinking. Okay, just go with that. You can do it from your home itself. And of course we are here, we Prominent Consultant are here, who represents more than 35 Canadian public universities. And University of Windsor, today we have live with them. It is one of the best public university based in Ontario. If you compare with the top ranked university based in Ontario, like University of Toronto, Waterloo, some other universities, If you compare with the fees of Windsor and the brand, so it is really very affordable. If you study in Windsor, they have very fantastic all kind of programs, from business, engineering, arts, humanities, every program they have. And I know this university is very competitive and very fantastic university, public university. So definitely we'll talk about all the matters of this university. Stay with us till next 1 hour. And of course, if you have any question regarding any kind of things of University of Windsor, we will be happy to answer you. And before asking your question, please mention your academic results, passing year, and an IELTS score, so that we can tell you perfectly after on spot assessment. And one more thing, that please don't forget to share this live session in your timeline, so people who are interested for a study in Canada, so they could be benefited from this live session. So we would like to welcome the person, the guest in this live session, Niharika, who is the international recruitment manager of South Asia. So Niharika, can you hear me?
Yes, I can, Sayed. How are you doing?
Yes, I am doing well. And how are you?
All good. Good evening, everyone.
Thank you so much. And I would like to request you, please say hello to our viewers and please introduce yourself.
Hello, viewers. I'm Niharika and I represent the University of Windsor. And this session has been organized by Prominent Consultants to talk about Windsor, to know about the entry requirements, scholarships, and the facilities that we provide. So feel free to ask questions.
Exactly. Thank you so much. So Niharika, before going to the serious topics, before going to the main topics, we will have a video first. So
okay.
It's a video about about the Windsor University, about their campus, about their activities, and it's located definitely in Ontario. So let's have the video first, and after the video we'll come back to our main session.
Sure.
It's taking a little bit time. So yes, Niharika, so I mean we just continue.
Okay,
we just continue talking. It's taking a little bit time, so we will we'll start talking about all the things. So as you know that of course, just a second. as you know that Canada is one of the top destination for higher studies definitely apart from Australia, UK and USA. So would you please tell me that why people should consider Canada as their higher as their destination of higher studies?
Canadian education is recognized all over the world. So the kind of degrees that we provide, the universities are all public universities and the degrees are recognized all over the world and have a lot of accreditation. So if you're looking at professional accreditations, there are accreditations attached to most of our programs. So that is one reason that you can look at Canada. Affordability wise, Canadian education is pretty much affordable if you compare it to UK or Australian institutes. So our tuition fees, the living expenses, they are very, very competitive. So that is another reason. At Canadian institutions, we are looking at providing you with a very safe and secure environment. I know when parents are thinking about sending their kids abroad, safety is the biggest concern. So at these institutions in Canada, we keep safety first. So the kind of atmosphere, the kind of campus life that you will experience there will be very safe and secure. So these are the top three points, I think, that people should look at Canadian education. Another advantage of a Canadian education is the stay back option that comes with the degrees. So if you're going for a 2-year degree or a 4-year program, you get to stay back in Canada, look out for jobs, apply for a permanent residency in the next 2 to 3 years. So these are some of the options that you can get while choosing a Canadian education.
Exactly. And one more thing that... Yes, sorry, actually there was some technical issue.
No problem. That's how we will learn to live the virtual life now, Syed.
No, it's okay because it was very perfect, but suddenly actually I don't know that somehow it has been, there is some problem anyway. So okay. So let's have the video first, okay?
No. All right.
Yes, it's a great video of University of Windsor, and in the video we can see that every programs are integrated with the practical works, and the class size is also very small, like 21:29. So it's a very fantastic option. So yes, Niharika, we are talking about about Canada. I mean, higher education in Canada, definitely, as you have said, definitely it's a safe country. Without any doubt, it's a multicultural country. I mean, you can feel the diversity in Canada, and of course, it's an English-speaking country. No language barrier. People are welcoming, friendly, and especially, I would say that people are, and the government is also immigration-friendly. That's so people can study, work, and settle in Canada. So it's the very unique option that people can choose Canada as for their higher studies. Now, actually, we know that there are a few provinces in Canada, like 10 provinces, and Ontario is known as the oldest and the largest province in Canada and the most developed province. And each province, as you know, that Niharika, has their own constitution, has their own education system. And
right.
In Ontario itself, there are a lot of cities, like Toronto is there, London is there, Thunder Bay is there, North Bay is there, Windsor is there, Waterloo is there. So, I mean, could you please tell me about Ontario and the location of Windsor, how the city is, and about the location of University of Windsor?
Sure. The University of Windsor is located at the southernmost tip of Ontario province. So if you have a look at the map, I wish I could show it to you right now, but I don't have access to the map at the moment on my phone. But it is at the tip of Ontario province, and it shares the border with US. It is the most active border between the two countries, as you would all know that US is our neighbor. So Detroit is the neighboring city to Windsor, and Windsor as a place is surrounded by the Five Lakes area. So we call it the Windsor Essex County, and the area is surrounded by these water bodies. Because of that, the weather in Windsor is pretty favorable. We get 7 months of half sleeve weather. So the snow or the rains that come during the seasons, they get cleared up very quickly. So that is one advantage of the location. The fact that we are at the borders of US and Canada, that is also seen as an advantage, because then you have the chance of getting into US, you have the chance of getting jobs in US, you have the chance of crossing the border while you are studying on the program also, and get a feel of the other side. So that is where we are located. We are around 3.5 hours drive from Toronto. Toronto being the more popular place in Canada. We are around 3.5 hours drive from Toronto. So it is pretty approachable from major cities. And Windsor itself has around 2,17,000 people staying there. And as a city, it is a very safe and welcoming city. And a lot of diversity there too. So we as a university welcome a lot of people, a lot of nationalities from all across the world. So you would see a very multicultural, safe and diverse atmosphere in the city.
Exactly. And you know that about the universities, if we talk about like in Ontario, there are few top universities. University of Toronto definitely is the number one without any doubt. And after that, there are few more universities like equally we treat them. Okay, so in terms of York, Ryerson, some of the universities are there also. So Windsor is one of them, one of the top ranked university from Ontario. So how could you define University of Windsor? I mean, how it could be a little bit exceptional, why people should choose University of Windsor? What are the highlighting points of this university?
The top few reasons to choose Windsor, I would say, is, if you go by a finger count, the first reason to go with the University of Windsor is definitely its location, the kind of place that we are situated in. There are multinational companies working across the border in Windsor, in that whole region, the Essex County region. So the location is very important. You have access to bigger cities. If you are not interested in getting into the bigger cities, then you can get into the smaller cities in Ontario province or just stay in Windsor. Affordability-wise, Windsor's tuition fee is very, very competitive. So if you're looking at universities, medium-sized universities in that same range, the tuition fees is very, very affordable. Then the third thing that I can think of is the kind of experiential learning that we provide along with our academics. So most of our programs are embedded with co-ops and internships that the students can make very good use of while they are studying on the program. So it gives you a mix of academics as well as learning beyond the classroom. So you get to experience hands-on learning while you are on the program. Since we are a medium-sized university and we concentrate on restricting the class size, as Syed introduced us initially, we try and restrict the class size into 30-35 odd. So that is one reason that the professors can pay equal attention to all their students. If there is a class full of, say, 100-150 people, you will feel lost in the crowd. But at Windsor, we try to maintain smaller class sizes so that you can make good use of the kind of experience that the professors are getting into the classroom. With 20-30 years of experience in their areas of expertise, in their areas of research, you can make very good use of that experience. The professors are able to pay equal attention to all the students that are there in their classes. So that is another reason, and the kind of diversity and a close-knit campus that we try to provide. Since we are a medium-sized university with smaller number of people in each faculty, we try and keep people connected all the time. So it is a very tightly knit campus, but a very modern campus too. So we have green spaces with modern buildings, and then you can see, like in the video, you could see some ancient buildings too. So there is a mix of modern and ancient while you are on the campus, a lot of green spaces there. And the kind of atmosphere that we try to build in the campus life itself is very, very good.
Exactly. And always we say one thing to our students that, see, whenever or wherever you invest your money for education, definitely you should invest it in a perfect place. If you invest more also, suppose if I talk about Windsor and the Canadian universities, definitely the fees are not affordable by all people, definitely. So, but the education quality, but the education in the field of learning, whatever you are learning, the output is really very outstanding. And whatever you investing to your education in Canada, you are the getting of, I don't know the how many percentage, but definitely double, triple, and more than that, you are getting the output from the education. The reason behind this, because in Canada, the education system is completely experiential learning based. Niharika, we know everyone that their program, they are everything structured with practical and theoretical. So the practical is learning is more over there. That's why when people are learning from the book, they are at the same time they are doing it. They are doing it with the companies, they are doing it with the labs, the real-time labs. So that what is happening after the graduation, immediately they are having a job, very fantastic job by all the companies. So that's the advantage of Canadian education. You no need to be worried about your financial investment to a Canadian education. So definitely you can apply to Canadian university, such kind of University of Windsor, definitely, and if you can afford, of course. So Niharika, as we know that Windsor have a lot of programs, especially in undergrad level. I know that so far I believe it's more than 100 programs.
And 200.
200, sorry, 200, and they are covering, I mean, if you just name it, you have it, something like that, the programs in Windsor. Yes. So we would like to know details about all kind of programs, all kind of faculties you have, and what are the most popular and most significant and most demandable programs in Windsor.
Okay. So faculty-wise, there are 9 different faculties that we have. We have a faculty of business, we have the faculty of engineering, we have the faculty of sciences, faculty of arts, humanities and social sciences. We also have the faculty of human kinetics, which is more towards the rehabilitation, physiotherapy side of it. We also have the faculty of education. So these are various faculties that are present at the university. Within these faculties, the kind of popular programs that we offer are your programs under the business arena. So if you're looking at business, commerce, entrepreneurship, marketing related, human resource related specializations, accounting and finance related specializations, we have all of those. Within the engineering faculty, which is one of the most popular faculties at the university, we have civil, industrial, environmental, mechanical. Mechanical has aerospace and automotive specializations too. It has materials and environmental specializations too. So these are the various realms within the engineering faculty. We also have the faculty of sciences, which has your normal physics, chemistry, biology, but it also has environmental sciences, forensic sciences, computer science, which are the more popular programs these days. Then we have the faculty of arts and humanities, which has programs like philosophy, sociology, international relations, economics, all that embedded into one faculty. That is the biggest faculty that we have. So there are many number of courses within the Faculty of Arts and Humanities that you can think of doing. You can also take different combinations. You can combine a business program with an economics from the Faculty of Arts if you're interested in widening your horizons. So we also have the Faculty of Human Kinetics, where you can specialize in sports management and movement sciences. So these are some of the more popular programs that we offer at the University of Windsor. These are all 4-year degrees at the undergrad level.
4-year degrees, exactly. And I think also you also have a Bachelor of Education as well.
Yes, Bachelor of Education is also there. Yep.
Yes, exactly. Because Bachelor of Education is a very demandable subject, because in Canada, there are a lot of people required in education field. So that's right. Also you can choose, exactly. And just we need to know about few facts about that. What are the most popular courses in Windsor? I mean, people can be confident about all these programs. I mean,
all our programs are internationally recognized and accredited. So when you're looking at the region there in Bangladesh, most people would look at going for business programs or engineering programs. So these are the programs that we have. Like you said, education is also one of the popular choices. We have that faculty too, so you can choose programs in these areas. As far as Windsor is concerned, the Odette School of Business is very highly ranked. If you have a look at the kind of qualifications that the professors come with within the Odette School of Business, they are very, very high class qualifications. So Odette School of Business, which offers the BCom and the Human Resource Business Administration related programs, that is one of the popular choices. Then the engineering faculty is another popular choice. Civil engineering, industrial engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, these are the programs that people look at. Aerospace, automotive being the more popular choices within mechanical engineering. So these days students are looking at pursuing these careers. We also have sciences. So our computer science program is within the Faculty of Science instead of engineering. So within the Faculty of Science, we have computer science, which has specializations in general, applied, information systems, and software engineering. So these are the kind of courses that are very popular among students who come from India, Bangladesh, and this region.
Exactly. And of course, dear viewers, as Niharika has said about all undergrad programs, definitely they're also offering some master's program as well, and in various fields, especially in education, in engineering. In engineering, they have very fantastic programs in terms of apply. I mean, they have also applied computing in master's. They have engineering in electrical, civil, mechanical, and one of the most popular course in Windsor, which is engineering management. And this is a very good program combination with engineering and management, and you can go for it if you have an engineering background. And also their master of management, what could I say, it's a very competitive course. It's very tough to get the seats of masters in management. They have three specialization in this program, like international supply chain, HR, and international finance and international accounting and finance. And also they have economics, they have some other programs, social studies, social work. One student, Mamun Hussein, he has asked any master of law. Actually, I'm not sure whether they have master of law. Most probably they have, but you need to check their graduate studies website link. So from that you can easily know. And just I'll have a quick review of the master's program, as we'll talk about mostly undergrad today. But for the master's program, mostly most of the programs are almost 2 years, four semesters. And like, you know, that the IELTS requirements is like, some program they are having, they need 7 and open less than 6.5. Some programs, yes, and some programs you can apply through IELTS 6.5 and open less than 6, some programs. And everything is mentioned in the website perfectly. You don't need to worry about that. And also you can see our name as well as authorized agent. So anything you can, if you need any assistance, you can take help from prominent. And about the fees, I would say about for masters, like it's varies from $35,000 Canadian to $40,000 near about for 2 years. And honestly speaking, it's really, really affordable. Really, really affordable. If I compare with masters in management, $40,000 near about $40,000 Canadian for 2 years, it's truly affordable. If you see about Waterloo for 1 year MBA program, they're asking $70,000 Canadian. So it's very affordable, and you can see, but very competitive. And I would say I would like to mention one important thing about masters. You should apply. Don't look for the deadline. Don't look for the deadline, please. You should apply at least 7 to 8 months or 9 months before the class date. Otherwise, there is very less chances to get the admission, because we know that how long it takes. It takes time. Because they are having a lot of applications for masters, so you need to apply very as soon as possible, as soon as you have all the documents. And for documents, you need some specific documents. Most of the programs, they're asking for 2 references, SOP, CV, if you have any work experience, everything you need to submit, and the application fee is $125 Canadian. So still, if you have any query, just feel free to talk to prominent consultant. So I think, Niharika, that's all for masters. So I have explained in a short way. So just a quick review about master's program. So now we'll talk about the entry requirements and academic average, IELTS requirement of all undergrad program. But before that, we will have another video, a very fantastic video of University of Windsor. So let's have the video first, okay?
Sure. Thank you.
Yes, it's a fantastic video, and the video covers most of the things about just a short review of University of Windsor. So Niharika, just before going to the admission part, I mean the admission requirement or the entry requirement part, so we would like to know about something about your co-op opportunities in your all programs and how it basically works and when students can get that opportunity in which year and how many co-op terms you have.
All right. So when we are looking at a four-year degree program, we offer co-op starting from the second year onwards. So when your first year results are out and you are looking for co-op opportunities in the second year, the co-op opportunities would be based on your first year's CGPA. So depending on the kind of CGPA or grades that you get in your first year, you can opt for co-op opportunities. Now, these opportunities are spread across the coming 3 years. Every year, you will have one term of co-op. One term is equal to 4 months. Each year is divided into three terms, two academic and one term for assessments, for co-ops and other activities. So starting from the second year, you can do one term of co-op each year. And it is embedded into the program, so it doesn't increase the length of the program, but you get that experience within those 4 years. So at the end of the 4 years, you have three terms or 12 months of co-op experience. And with that, you can approach companies. The co-op experience is actually listed in your transcripts. So the kind of companies you've worked with, the amount of time you've spent with them, the profile that you've worked with them for, everything is mentioned in your transcript. So when you are approaching an employer after you complete these 4 years of academic as well as experiential learning thing, the employers look at you in a very different light because you already know the nuances of how things work in a business place, in a factory, in an industry. So you've had the opportunity to do three different terms, three different co-ops every year. I mean, a four-year degree has three terms of co-op and you can choose different co-ops each year. So you get the taste of a company, an industry, maybe a research unit, and you can add that to your CV, which will add real value and which will make you more marketable when you are getting into the job force.
Exactly.
Just to add to it, these co-op opportunities are paid opportunities. So you're actually getting paid for the kind of co-op work you are doing. On an average, we have seen that students earn up to 10 to 11,000 Canadian dollars for three terms of co-op. So in a year, you can earn around 10 to 11,000 Canadian dollars. How much would that be in your Bangladeshi taka, Syed?
Yes. I'm just telling it will be like 6 lakhs or 7 lakhs.
So in a year you can make 6 to 7 lakhs, which is equivalent to your living expenses.
I will explain Bangla that matter, but before that I will take a question of Jakir Hussain. It's just for masters in accounting. Yes, Jakir, we just have talked about masters in management major. You can take international accounting and finance definitely if you have IELTS 7 overall, no band less than 6.5. And still we are taking applications for winter 21, but you need to apply as quick as possible because seats are honestly going to be closed very fast. You don't even you don't imagine that how fast it is closing. So our one student, he already got, you know, that Niharika one student, we applied for September, he has IELTS 8.5, but he has been transferred for to the waiting list of January. So just be conscious about this matter. So the thing you are talking about, like co-op, ami jodi ektu banglay boli, right, students see Windsor e kintu charta 4 years er program every year apnader kintu tinta term, okay, summer, fall and winter. So dekha jacche je apni duita term e porashona korben, apni ekta term e apni co-op korben. Co-op ta kintu erokom na je you are doing some odd job. Like part-time job, you are working in some restaurants, in some some coffee shop, some what is not relevant to your program. You are working whatever you are getting. Okay, so but co-op is something you are working in your relevant industry. The job portion, it's a full-time job. Okay, so from the second year taking the co-op start, the benefits, number one, you are earning every টার্ম, আমি 4 মাসে যদি একটা টার্ম ধরি, আপনি একটা টার্মে আর্ন করছেন প্রায় 12,000, ইভেন মোর দ্যান দ্যাট, বেসড অন ইয়োর প্রোগ্রাম, বেসড অন ইয়োর ক্যাপাসিটি অ্যান্ড বেসড অন দ্য কোম্পানি, অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দ্য কোম্পানি ইউ ক্যান আর্ন মোর দ্যান দ্যাট এলস, বাট মিনিমাম ইউ ক্যান আর্ন 10,000 to 12,000. সো in three terms you can earn around 30,000 to 36,000 or maximum 40,000 Canadian dollar through co-op, through three terms co-op, and it is not increasing or extending your course duration. The course duration will not be increased. You can finish co-op with the theoretical part as well within 4 years. Now the second and the other opportunities for co-op, number one, I have said you that you are getting salary and which can cover some portion of your tuition fees or living expense, whatever you can say, because living expense you can also recover from your part-time jobs, definitely is possible. But co-op money, the amount you are getting from co-op, of course, if you talk about like engineering fees of Windsor, it's like 30,000, almost near about 30,000 per year. So it's coming around $120,000. So if you are earning through co-op 40,000, so you see just minus 40,000 from 120, so you need to spend only 80,000. Okay. So, and also there are some scholarship as well. Of course, Niharika will tell about scholarship. There are some certain scholarship. Also, if you are eligible for the scholarship, you will find a lot of opportunities. In that case, you can also no need to sometimes take the contribution from your parents as well. So there's a thing, if you maintain properly, if you are eligible, if you can do well in your program, if you have good CGPA, definitely you can do a lot of things. And the most vital thing of co-op, that you are getting connection of the industry, of the companies during your graduation period, during your study period, which is not possible in South Asia. You can see we are doing internship at the last semester and it's not a paid, and there is no connectivity, such kind of connectivity of the companies with the company. But in Canada, while you are working from the second year with the companies is marking you, recognizing you that you are Rohim, you are Korim, and you are you can be one of the best part of that company. So definitely you are going to be hired, you are going to be appointed just after completion of your degree in that company. It could be very much possible if you work through co-op. Co-op is such a platform, not only for যে আপনাকে শুধু টাকা দিচ্ছে তা না, আপনাকে স্যালারি দিচ্ছে তা না, আপনাকে একটা এক্সপোজার দিচ্ছে এবং আপনি সিভিতে উল্লেখ করতে পারছেন যে আপনার ফুল টাইম ওয়ার্ক এক্সপিরিয়েন্স আছে ইন দ্য রিলেভেন্ট ফিল্ড, যেটা আপনার ভবিষ্যতে গ্রাজুয়েশন করার পরে বিশাল একটা কাজে দিবে, রাইট নিহারিকা? হোয়াট এভার আই হ্যাভ সেইড.
And at times, when you are doing co-ops with these companies, if the companies are impressed by your efforts, by your inputs, they actually absorb you at the end of your four-year degree. The same companies might come out looking for you, saying that we want this person if you have managed to impress them in your co-op terms.
Exactly. And dear viewers, আপনাদের যদি কোনো question থাকে, আপনাদের অনেকে বলছেন আপনারা question করতে চাচ্ছেন, যারা যাদের কোনো question আছে, প্লিজ আপনারা কমেন্টসে লিখুন এবং আপনাদের details টা লিখে জানান আমাদেরকে, আপনাদের academic background, IELTS score. So we'll try to answer your question definitely. But if you can't answer, if you can't make us the question properly, then it's not possible to answer your question. So Niharika, we need to talk about the entry requirements of all your bachelor courses, including IELTS.
Yep. So when we talk about entry requirements as per the Ontario standards, we are looking at a minimum of 70% to gain entry into the programs. And each faculty has a different scale of entry point. So if you're looking at the Faculty of Arts and Humanities, 70% Ontario standards is what we are looking at. If you're looking at the Faculty of Sciences, we are looking at 75%. If you're looking at the Faculty of Engineering, again, 75% Ontario standards. The business faculty has the highest entry point, so we're looking at 78% Ontario standards. The business, engineering and science faculty require maths. So if you are wanting to apply for any of these faculties, you should have maths in your 11th and 12th. Then coming on to the IELTS or English proficiency requirements, we are looking at 6.5 overall scores with nothing less than 6 in each band. If you've given TOEFL, then we're looking at 83 TOEFL scores. So depending on what qualification you have, these are the kind of entry requirements.
Exactly. And I think because of COVID-19, you are also accepting Duolingo, which is
also accepted. Yeah, 120 is the score that we're looking at Duolingo.
Exactly. And students, you can apnara Duolingo ta kintu bashay boshei apnara dite parben, no need to go to any test center. So it's a very easy process. You can also register through online and you can give your exam on online from itself from your home. So it's a very easy steps, easy process. You can easily do it from home, and also you can get the result very quickly, within 4 to 5 days. So you can go for it, because now all centers are closed and they are not taking any exams. So Duolingo can be one of the best option for you. And of course, Windsor, as Niharika, we know that if you even don't have IELTS now or at this moment, you can also apply conditionally. You can get the conditional offer letter. Even you can also get the conditional offer letter through your predictive results of A2 levels or HSC level. You can go with your predictive results. Windsor is you know that they are taking care of your applications, and they will give you the conditional offer letter. And of course, after a certain period, you need to fulfill the condition to go for the main program. Okay, so Niharika, the thing is that what about the fees structure? Fees structure, first of all, you need to know. And how about the payment system? I mean, what kind of installment do you offer? And what about the scholarship exactly?
Okay. So moving on to the fee structure of the university, the fee ranges from $23,500 Canadian and goes up to $28,500 Canadian. So if you're looking at the Faculty of Arts and Humanities, the fees would be around $23,000 Canadian. If you're looking at technical programs or business programs, the fees would be nearly about $28,500 Canadian. The fees, this is just the tuition fee. Living expenses are separate. $8,000 to $10,000 Canadian if you plan to stay on campus. So this is a sort of breakup of tuition and living expenses that you can keep. And scholarships are all academic merit based. So in case you have been scoring well in your 10th, 11th and 12th, there are loads of scholarships to offer. So the scholarship, the minimum amount of scholarship is 1,000, which is entrance scholarships for meritorious students. You need to have 85% and above. You have to be academically very good to be able to qualify for these scholarships. But if you have been a meritorious student, you can get various amounts. So minimum is 1,000, maximum is 16,000. So that's the President's Award, and it can be divided into 4 years. So 4,000 each year you will get for the President's Award. But for that, you need to have very good scores, 95 plus in your 10th and 12th boards, HSC, SSC, whatever you are giving, you need to have very good scores. So there are various scholarships to give out. You just need to fill in the application, submit all your documents, and you will be assessed automatically. You don't have to separately apply for scholarships. Our database picks up students who have more than 85%, and then our scholarship team looks at the applications and allots scholarships.
Exactly. Niharika, I just have a specific question, because when you see the offer letter of University of Windsor, so they are telling about the tuition fees, about 2 terms and 3 terms. So
That's
if the student takes 3 terms, so the fees are increasing. I mean, instead of 28, it is increasing to like near about 40 or 40 above. So, I mean, students can pay up to 2 terms in a year, or
The 2 terms are the academic terms, actually. So the students have to pay for the academic term. The third term in most cases would either be a co-op or would be examination fees and other incidental fees. So the student needs to pay for the 2 academic terms. So each year they will have only 2 academic terms, and that is the amount of fees that they will need to pay. On our website, there is a tuition fee estimator. So if you go by your level of study and by the faculty of study, you can actually see each term's tuition fee. So you can see that each term you will have to pay around 6,000 to 8,000 Canadian dollars. So depending on how many terms you take, the tuition fee will multiply.
Exactly, Niharika. So we know that the Business School of Windsor is a very reputed business school in Canada. So let's have a video of your business school, someone's story of business.
Good.
I'm passionate about entrepreneurship. I always dreamed about having my own business and all that. And after I got part of different competitions, entrepreneurship competitions on campus and with Epicenter, I've come to realize that that's kind of the career path I want to follow. And that helped me like figure it out. I'm doing a double degree here at the University of Windsor. So I'm studying business and economics. I really enjoy my program. I also try to get involved as much as I can with different communities around campus. I get involved a lot with international students and try to help them or organize events for them. Also, I'm involved with different clubs and organizations and that. I think that being involved is good because you get to know different people. You also gain a lot of experience and make new skills that I can use further for my resume or when I'm applying for jobs. It's also good that I can apply the skills that I learn in classroom in real life. Prepared me for my future career. I got the chance to apply my skills through different volunteering opportunities. I volunteered as a consultant for food businesses, and that's where I got to apply my my knowledge from. I would recommend University of Windsor to my friends from back home because it's so welcoming. It's easy to find help from people and to feel like home. I'd also recommend my program to potential students because it's very exciting.
It's just a short video of someone's story about business faculty. That's good. And just we need to know about the accommodation options in University of Windsor. I think you also have the on-campus accommodation. And yep. how about the costing? How about the average living expenses in Windsor, and whether students can take their that accommodation personal arrangement, and how about the off-campus accommodation cost?
All right. On campus, we have around 4 residential halls which the students can choose from. These residential halls will cost you roughly between 7,000 Canadian dollars to 10,000 Canadian dollars, depending on the kind of facilities you opt for. Just one point to make before I start telling you about the bifurcation of the cost. International students at the undergrad level for the first year of study are guaranteed accommodation. So we have around 900 rooms to let out, and international students who are going for the first time and in the first year of their studies at the undergrad level, they are guaranteed accommodation. Provided you apply well within the deadline, you will be getting to stay on campus. So our suggestion would always be that at least for the first 2 terms, the 8 months that you are getting into a new place, getting into a new atmosphere, try and stay on campus because it is more convenient, it is much safer, and you have proximity to everything. There are doctors on campus, there are counselors on campus, people can reach you at any time of the day. And there is assistance provided 24/7. So for the first 8 months, the undergrad students who are going, the recommendation is always to stay on campus. Now coming to the kind of cost that you're looking at, if you are going into the university provided accommodations without meals, it will cost you around 7,000 Canadian dollars. If you're opting for meal options, if you're including 2 or 3 meals in a day, then it will be costing you around 10,000. Again, single occupancy, double occupancy, depending on what choices you have, whether you want to choose a flatmate beforehand, whether you want floors with only females or only males, all that option is given. So I would suggest that you go on to the residence website of our university and see the kind of options that are available. So the cost will depend on the kind of changes that you want in your accommodation. off campus, there are many landlords that advertise on our website. There's a whole list which you can choose from. But you'll have to go and suss out the accommodation, or if you have anybody you know there, can go and suss out the accommodation that is provided off campus. There is no guarantee that we can take as a university. But I have seen students getting into groups of 4 or 5 and taking flats, 2-bedroom, 3-bedroom flats outside campus, which is slightly cheaper. They may be 10 minutes, 15 minutes walk from to the campus, but the students who don't want to spend $10,000 Canadian on the accommodation provided by the university, they tend to stay. And if they have a group of friends, so they can stay with them together and feel more at home, cook your own things, etc. So this is the kind of variation that we have within the accommodations.
Exactly. And one more thing that I mean, we can say in average, they need to spend around $800 to $1,000 Canadian dollar per month. If I compare with the meal and the rent, so I can calculate that it's coming near about $1,000 Canadian. And as you know, that from South Asia, especially from Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, and some of the nationalities from South Asia, they will be looking for some part-time jobs doing over there, as they are permitted to do part-time jobs 20 hours in a week, and full-time definitely in summer vacations. So, I mean, how is the opportunity of doing part-time jobs in the city of Windsor, and how the city is, and what kind of the facilities are given to the Windsor students locally?
At the University of Windsor, we have seen a lot of students working on campus. So the university provides with a lot of opportunities which are available on campus. So you can work in different departments of the university. You can work with the residential services as an international student. You can work with our international student support team. We have a very big group of international students working on databases, working on event organization. So all these sort of jobs are available for international students. You can also work with professors as on the research projects. There are opportunities at the master's level of getting into teaching assistantship, research assistantship, graduate assistantship on campus. Off campus, there are opportunities of working in stores, in restaurants, in malls, whatever you can think of. You can work for 20 hours a week, and the minimum wage is around $11 per hour.
Exactly. And just a quick discussion about the application process for undergrad program.
Application process is through OUAC, which is the centralized Ontario University's application center, and you can apply to 3 universities within Ontario province. You can also directly apply to us through the University of Windsor's website. Prominent is there to help you and assist you in the application process, in the visa process. Everything is online, so you just have to upload the documentation. We're looking at your 10th, 11th, and 12th scores. Keeping in mind the current situation, we are giving out conditional offers based on your class 12 predicted grades, as Syed was telling. We have extended the deadlines of applications so students can still apply for the September intake. So because of the situation since March, when our applications closed, the whole world is actually under a lockdown. So we decided to extend the application submission deadline. We have kept in mind that institutions are also closed, so students are not able to get their final transcripts. There are some institutions which have not been able to hold their examinations, so examinations have gotten postponed. So all that has been taken into consideration by our registrar's office, by the senior management at the university, and we have decided to extend all our deadlines. So application submission deadline is extended until August. The documentation submission deadline is also extended until August, so that the students, I know in India, the CBSE board, the ICSE board is going to conduct the examinations, the pending or the remaining examinations in July. So if your boards there in Bangladesh are going to conduct examinations in June or July, that's what I've heard from my associates there, that you can actually apply for a conditional offer. And then when in July or August, when you have have your final grades, you can submit it to us. With a conditional offer, you can actually apply for your visas also. So once the visa services are open, you can apply with a conditional offer. So there is an extension in all sorts of deadlines. You need to pay a deposit once you submit your application and you get an offer letter. There is a $1,000 Canadian deposit that you need to pay. For master's students, there is a $4,000 Canadian deposit that they need to pay to reserve your seat. So the sooner you pay it, the more guarantee you have of going to Canada or reserving your seat. So this is the minimum deposit that you need to pay to reserve your seat. And then you can pay your fees in installments if you're not applying to the SDS process, where you have to pay a whole year's tuition fee. But fees can be paid in installments. Every term you can pay the fees.
Exactly. Thank you so much for your quick explanation. And I would like to say something in Bengali that the total application process, like application fee, jodi apnara Windsor er website er through the amra apply kori, tahole application fee ta besh kom. Jodi apni OUAC theke apply kore, fees ta beshi asche. But if we apply directly to University of Windsor, it's coming $75 Canadian for undergrad. And you need to submit just your academic transcripts, and if you have predictive score, suppose you are still waiting for your HSC exam, but you can easily give us the predictive score of your HSC or A-level or whatever you have in class 12. And you can get the conditional offer letter, and conditional offer letter power pore kintu apnake $1,000 deposit korte hobe jeta hocche seat confirmation er jonno, ha subject confirmation er jonno dewar pore kintu apni easily visa er jonno submit korte parben. Ebong onekei bhoy pacchen je VFS jete ekhon bondho, so how apnara kibhabe visa er jonno submission korben, eta apnader jonno ekta big headache hoye ekhon ache. So amra ektu clear korte chai, seta hocche je amra sadharonoto ekhon kintu visa application gulo online e submit korchi. Online there is option এবং আপনি VFS টা কিন্তু আমাদের দরকার হচ্ছে মূলত বায়োমেট্রিকের জন্য. সো বায়োমেট্রিকটা কিন্তু আপনি অ্যাপ্লিকেশনের পরে আরো 30 আরো 3 মান্থস 90 ডেজ আপনাকে সময় দিচ্ছে টু গেট দ্য বায়োমেট্রিক. সো আমার মনে বায়োমেট্রিক নিয়ে তো ওরিড হওয়ার কোনো দরকার নেই. আমরা ভিসা দা অ্যাপ্লিকেশনটা আমরা অনলাইনে সাবমিট করতে পারবো, এবং আপনি ভিসা পেলে আপনি যদি ইনকেস ফ্লাই করতে নাও পারেন তারপরেও কিন্তু আপনি অনলাইনে ক্লাস শুরু করতে পারবেন, যেটা ক্যানাডিয়ান গভর্নমেন্ট অলরেডি দে হ্যাভ ডিক্লেয়ার্ড যে আপনি যদি 50% ক্লাস ইভেন বাসায় বসেও কমপ্লিট করেন তাহলে কিন্তু আপনি you will be treated as মানে ফিজিক্যালি আপনি যা করলে যে সুবিধাটুকু আপনি পেতেন সেম সুবিধাই আপনি পাচ্ছেন. আপনার পিজিডব্লিউপি তে কোনো এফেক্ট হবে না, আপনি ইট উইল বি নরমাল. আপনি আপনি পিজিডব্লিউপি এর জন্য এলিজিবল হবেন, আপনি পিআর এর জন্য এলিজিবল হবেন, যে সুবিধাগুলো ছিল সেগুলোই থাকবে, জাস্ট আপনি বাসায় থেকে আপনাকে ক্লাস করতে হবে. এবং আরেকটি জিনিস নিয়ারিকা যেটা আমি আরেকটু বলতে চাই, যে অনেকে মনে করছে যে অনলাইনে ক্লাস করলে হয়তো বা প্রফেসর ভিন্ন হবে বা হয়তো বা ক্লাসগুলো ভিন্ন হবে, এটা কিন্তু হবে না. আসলে এটা নিয়ে আপনাদের রেডার কোনো দরকার নেই, বিকজ ইউনিভার্সিটি কিন্তু আপনাকে সেম ক্লাস সেম থিং প্রোভাইড করবে, বিকজ দে আর টেকিং দ্য সেম অ্যামাউন্ট. সো ওয়াই ডোন্ট দে ওয়াই উইল নট দে গিভ ইউ দ্য রাইট থিং. অ্যান্ড ওয়ান মোর থিং, দ্যাট দ্য মেইন অ্যাডভান্টেজ ইজ দ্যাট ইউ আর সেভিং your living expenses, because আপনি যদি ক্যানাডাতে গিয়ে পড়তে হতো আপনি 6 মাস, তাহলে 6 মাসে আপনার একটা ভালো লিভিং এক্সপেন্স লাগতো, তাই না? যেটা আমাকে নিহারিকা বললো যে যদি আমি $1,000 করে হিসাব করি $12,000 ইন এ ইয়ার, তো 6 মাস যদি আপনি ক্যানাডা থেকে না গিয়ে যদি বাংলাদেশে বসে পড়েন তাহলে কিন্তু আপনার $6,000 Canadian সেভ হচ্ছে, যেটি কিন্তু আপনি আবার আপনার আবার নেক্সট সেমিস্টারে টিউশন ফিজের সাথে আপনি অ্যাড করতে পারছেন. সো এরকম বেশ কিছু সুবিধা আছে অনলাইনে ক্লাস করলে যে আপনি আপনার জন্য আমি মনে করি আরো ভালো. হ্যাঁ, আপনি বাসায় থাকলেন, বাবা মার সাথেই থাকলেন, মার রান্না খেয়েই আপনি ক্লাস করলেন বাসায় বসে. আর ক্লাসটা এরকম না যে আপনার সপ্তাহে প্রতিদিনই হবে, বা আপনার এরকম না যে আপনার সারাদিন ক্লাস হবে, হয়তো বা ইটস ম্যাটার অফ 2-3 hours, 4 hours এরকমই হবে. সো আপনি বাসায় বসে রিল্যাক্স কফি খেতে খেতে ক্লাস করবেন, এর থেকে ভালো অপরচুনিটি আর কি হতে পারে? যেহেতু আমরা এখন চাইলেও আমরা ক্যানাডা মুভ করতে পারবো না, আমাদের পক্ষে পসিবল না, ইটস এ গ্লোবাল ক্রাইসিস, আপনি আমি চাইলেও আমরা পারবো না. সো আমাদেরকে পরিস্থিতির সাথে অ্যাডজাস্ট করতে হবে, আমাদেরকে পরিস্থিতির সাথে আমাদেরকে চলতে হবে, এভাবে আমাদেরকে মেনে নিতে হবে, আমাদেরকে ছাড়া কোনো উপায় নেই. সো নিহারিকা, উই আর জাস্ট এন্ড অফ দ্য লাইভ সেশন, বাট আমরা তার আগে একটা ভিডিও দেখবো, ক্যাম্পাস লাইফ অফ ইউনিভার্সিটি অফ উইন্ডসর, ঠিক আছে?
All right.
Yes, through the campus life.
Yeah, it mentioned clubs and societies, which I forgot while interacting. So there are more than 200 clubs and societies related to music, arts, theatre, athletics, sports that you can be a part of. I mean, it's not just about academics. It's also about honing your personal development skills, your hobbies, etc.
Exactly. And you know that আমরা সবাই জানি যে পড়াশোনার যেটা আমাদের কানাডাতে প্র্যাকটিস হয়, যেটা কানাডা ইউনিভার্সিটি গুলোতে প্র্যাকটিস হয়, সেটা হচ্ছে যে বিয়ন্ড ইউর ক্লাসেস, বিয়ন্ড ইউর ট্রেডিশনাল এডুকেশন, যেটা হচ্ছে যে আপনার যে এক্সট্রা কারিকুলার, লট অফ ক্লাবস, লট অফ স্পোর্টস, লট অফ এক্সট্রা কারিকুলার অ্যাক্টিভিটিস, যেটা কিন্তু কানাডিয়ান ইউনিভার্সিটি গুলোর ক্যাম্পাস ইজ ফুল অফ ডাইভার্সিটি, এটা খুব দরকার আমাদের লাইফে। বিকজ আমরা ডাইভার্সিটির মধ্যে না থাকলে আমরা আসলে নেটওয়ার্ক বিল্ড আপ করতে পারবো না, উইচ ইজ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট। সো নিহারিকা, এনি উই আর জাস্ট এন্ড অফ দ্য লাইভ সেশন, এন্ড এনি লাস্ট ওয়ার্ড ইউড লাইক টু শেয়ার টু আওয়ার ভিউয়ার্স?
Just that stay in touch with prominent consultants who will help you in all the application process. We are still accepting at the undergrad level, we are still accepting applications for the fall intake. At the postgrad level, graduate level, January is the next available intake, and you can apply until the 1st of July. For undergrad students, please apply for either fall or January, whatever you are comfortable in. As far as the delivery of the courses is concerned, until December 31st, there will be an online delivery of the programs. So as Syed was explaining, you can take the programs from the comfort of your homes. You don't have to go anywhere. It's just that you have to get adjusted with the different time zones, because your classes may start at 6 or 6:30 in the evening and go on till 10 or 10:30, which is manageable. I know most people don't sleep until, at your age at least, don't sleep until 10, 11 in the night. So you can do 3 to 4 hours.
They sleep in midnight always. I know. Because my small kids, they are sleeping, you know, that at 1 a.m., 2 a.m. So everyone is sleeping in that
time. So I think after evening
is always better for them.
Actually, it is always better because you are done for the day, whatever work you need to do and finish during the day, and then you can start your online classes. Till December, it is not safe to travel anywhere. So safety, as I was telling you, is our first priority. That is why the university has decided to hold online classes until the 31st of December. You don't have to worry about your postgraduate work permit, because even if you do 50% of your course online, you will be eligible for that. We will try and give you the experience that you would expect to get in classrooms. So there would be a lot of talks, a lot of lectures, a lot of self-assessments. The examinations will be conducted online too. So you will get a feel of the university while you are doing the online course. You don't have to worry about it. It's just that you need to have a very good network connectivity and some peace of mind to conduct or take those classes in the evenings at the Bangladesh time. And thank you very much, everyone, for attending and listening through all the conversations that Syed and I have had. Hope it was useful. Request you to stay inside, stay safe, and hopefully we will be able to meet in person very soon, maybe in 2021 now. I don't see traveling to Bangladesh in 2020, but definitely in 21, when I travel to Bangladesh, we will definitely meet in person. Thank you, Syed.
Thank you so much, Niharika. I would like to conclude this live session. Before conclusion, I just want to say something that please stay in home, stay safe. And of course, this live session, কিন্তু এটা ফেসবুকে আমাদের থাকবে all the time, and আমাদের ইউটিউব চ্যানেলেও এটা পাবলিশ করা হবে। আপনাদের ইউনিভার্সিটি উইন্ডসর সম্পর্কে যাবতীয় যা কিছু জানার আপনারা এই লাইভ সেশন থেকে জানতে পারবেন, এবং এই জন্যই কিন্তু আমরা লাইভ সেশনটা অর্গানাইজ করেছি যে through the video you can learn everything. And if still if you have any question, any further question, feel free to contact with prominent and we'll be happy to answer your all queries. And that's the Niharika said, still we have time till August, so definitely we are organizing some open day for University of Windsor in month of June after Eid festival. You will be getting the announcement very soon, open day of University of Windsor, and through the open day you can also apply instant. So thank you so much for watching the live video. And Niharika, thank you so much for joining, and you please be here, don't go, don't leave the studio. Okay. I'm just closing the live session and I'm coming back to you. Okay,
thank you. Sure.
Yeah, viewer, thank you so much. Stay safe, take care of yourself, and stay in home. Thank you.